7 p.m. is Schoengrabern, which means we're on our level time. So top of the hour, we see Touche has two lost battalions and one routed for a total of three. Grenadiers are, well, bruised but not terribly battered. And Legrand has lost one battalion. Russians are a little worse off. They are down 8 battalions out of 17. So we look at the morale level chart. See, Legrand has 1 battalion lost. And on the board, we have 1 battalion routed. So that puts him at a level 1. Grenadiers are still good. Suchet has 2 lost and 1 routed. So he remains on a 1. And the Romanov rear guard, with 8 battalions lost, will now be on a level 2. So with 2 divisions on morale levels for the French, they really don't have much choice but to just press forward. Since we have no cavalry to charge, still bottled up in the vineyards, let's just kind of move forward with our movement phase here. See this French cavalry in the woods. We'll just kind of try to loop them around those Cossacks. See the French here. Just gonna try to move up the path. With the extreme movement restrictions, we only get 2 hexes up the path. Pulling back a little, we see just a column of French moving up that path, plus the routed men there. I think I'm going to leave Suchet with that routed battalion because we need to try to rally them. Let's move over to the Grenadiers and see if we can get them moving forward. Grenadiers have better movement potential, so they might be able to engage across the board here. Now, if you remember, there's only one increment remaining of that Grenadier battalion for the Russians. So we're going to try to get some infantry up next to them and see if we can't engage. Our movements in the vineyard are 3 movement points, and these are all with the light night effects, 6 movement point battalions, so they're able to just move forward pretty slowly. We'll just engage with those skirmishers against those grenadiers. Now let's move across to the west side. Unfortunately, I've stranded Legrand in the vineyard, and he's really unable to make good progress. Most of these battalions have 5 movement points, 3 expended per hex, which doesn't get them very far at all. They can move our light infantry 2 hexes since they are 8 movement points. I'm trying to angle everybody back towards the path. I do have some French cavalry sitting right out here. They don't really have anywhere they can go particularly. They have that large Russian unit right there. As soon as they emerge from the vineyard, they're going to get pounced on. So they should probably wait as long as they can, and then try to draw that cavalry away from their infantry. So we're going to leave them right there in that vineyard until we get a little further along. So that should conclude our movement phase. Let's go ahead to the Russian defensive fire phase. The French weren't able to really get into contact very, very much on the west side here. We have that one grenadier battalion can fire at those skirmishers. You just throw some dice, and it can be hard for those grenadiers in general order to make any real effect. And they did not with a low dice roll. Let's move down to the center in the east. So we have shots here, 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 and here. So we'll see here some guns firing, but probably not a lot in the way of casualties. And as I say that, on the first attack here, we roll a 65. That should be more than enough for a casualty. So we're going to inflict a casualty here on these grenadiers in skirmish order. It is a third increment loss, so no morale checks. They check on even numbered. But still good work by the Russian grenadiers there. Moving down the line, I rolled another nice number of 56. And that will inflict a casualty here. That's a second casualty. Morale check. The number is a 54 on the dice, so they will pass. Don't even have to look at it. I'm pretty sure the grenadiers do not have a 55 morale. So we move down the line. The Russians are much more accurate this turn. Last turn they were rolling terribly. This turn they've thrown another nice high number. But that is a one increment battalion remaining. That'll be 3.5 against Vineyard 10. So I don't think we quite make a loss there. Which means, despite a nice roll, we'll just move down the line and keep firing. Low number here. Another low number. Well, the last number is a good 66. I guess boxcars should always yield a hit, shouldn't it? So we'll inflict some damage on those light infantrymen there. So we'll just keep going and continue with the French phase here, firing those guys right in the back. Here we've got two battalions able to combine on one. And they roll a 12, when you know. We have another two battalions here. That should be another big high number in the 60s. With those two combining, I'm sure we'll at least get a 1-1, and that will destroy that battalion. And we have two more fires to finish off on the center and the right here. So with these two skirmishers combining, we roll a 52 on a 1-1 attack, so that is a loss. That's his second loss. It should be a morale check. We have a morale dice of 44, so they pass. Now we'll just move on to the west side. And we have the one position here. These skirmishers and two hexes can fire on that one grenadier. And a low number, so no final casualty. So we can move on to the melee phase and see if we have any attacks we want to make. Since we have so little contact in the west, our only attacks are going to be here in the center in the east. The French are going to be pretty aggressive just because of the time constraints. So we're going to launch these grenadiers at this unit here, which we will then see is a two increment Jaeger unit. French can muster three increments. Go for the pre-melee morale check. They're all good. Good middle number, so they'll pass. Now they'll move on to a melee. So the French can muster nine melee factors against two-thirds of five melee factors. And with the French General Odino and the Russian leaders, that's a net plus three on the dice. So that was a big roll. You rolled a 64. And that is a leader casualty, which in our case ends up being a head wound, as well as the defender disorder. So the Russian is killed. Send flowers to the widow. And we disorder and retreat three hexes. Good outcome for the French. And we have another attack here. We can muster three increments from each of these French battalions against two of the Russian, so the pre-melee morale check. Very poor number. Rolled a 12 for this first one, so that's a disorder. For the next one, 61, a good morale check. So they pass and are able to drive home their attack. So again, they can muster three increments. That's 8.5 melee points against 2/3 of seven. Without any leader modifiers, that's a 1.5-to-1 attack. We rolled a 44, which is bad for the French because that's three attacker losses to one defender. So we knocked down those grenadiers a bit, but the French grenadiers take a big loss. They will now be five increments, so they're down to one in this battalion. So that was a pretty rough combat right there. And we have another attack right here. That's four increments. And the French can muster, three increments, and the French can muster three. So now they'll run their pre-melee morale check. 52, so they will pass. So the French can throw nine melee factors against 5.5. And then the Russians have a leader modifier of two. So a 33 minus two, that ends up being a blank result. So the French will retreat, and the Russians will retreat up that path. So we have one last attack right here. The Russians have one increment remaining, and the French can muster three. Pre-melee morale check passes. They have seven melee factors against 2/3 of seven again. That's 1/3 of seven. And that ends up being about a 3-to-1 attack with the minus two leadership modifier. So with the final result of the 26 on 3-to-1, that is two French losses and a morale check. So they go to 3 increment losses. Morale dice are 56, so they pass. But it's also 3 Russian losses, so they only have 1 guy remaining. They're destroyed. And that leader will jump to that other hex. The French will occupy that last hex. Now we have 1 last attack. Cavalry in the trees here. So these 2 light cavalry regiments want to melee those Cossacks, but Cossacks being Cossacks, they have a larger movement potential and can retreat out of the way. So we will move that regiment into that hex to occupy it. And that should complete the French melee phase. So some costly successes for the French, but they're going to have to trade people for ground right now. So we can move on to the rally phase. And we see we have that disordered unit there. Let's try to rally him. Nice high number, 54, so he comes back. We have Suchet's routed battalion just out of frame here. Now he is on a morale level, and I rolled a 14, so he remains routed. Now on the west side, Legrand has a routed battalion. We have a 41, so he's routed. He has a 26, Legrand is a plus 3. Legrand is also on a morale level, so basically that's a wash and he does recover. So now we have to rout our Suchet's man on the east side here. Fortunately, we're in the tangles of the vineyard, so he's not going to get very far. He only has 8 movement points, and he can move 2 hexes. So it'll take him a long time to get out of there. Without any cavalry to recover, that should do it for the French half of the turn. He can move on to the Russians. Well, the Russian left and center have basically fallen apart. We have some Cossacks, a little bit of infantry, but otherwise, they're falling back or getting destroyed. The right is the most is in the best shape, only because they're so far back in the vineyard that they're not in risk of being outflanked. So I think on this turn we're going to try to shift some defenses to the left and the center and try to stem the tide. Let's just get started with the Russian movement phase. Cossacks are going to be our friends because they can run away. So we'll just try to keep them in position here to block that French cavalry. As far as the Russian infantry goes, there's really nowhere to run. Their best bet is probably to stick right there. The only one I think we can do something with is this Cossack. That is the Dragoons. I think we should move these Dragoons up into this area, give them a chance at either skirmishing. Well, I guess maybe this is the area. They should get into skirmish and try to hold off the advancing French infantry. More towards the center, this infantry needs to get out of there. They're going to take a shot from those skirmishers when they move away. But fortunately, it's not enough to damage them. So they only have 5 movement points, 3 for the vineyard, gets them not very far. On the west side, we have the prince in Pichel. Actually, probably German, so it's probably a harder pickle. We have some grenadiers sitting right here. Right now, they're not in bad shape, but we really need to get them at least one hex over and away from the French. We don't want to expose ourselves to any more melees. So we're going to move this guy one here, suffer the opportunity fire, no casualties, and I think we can call that our movement for the French, or no, the Russian, sorry. Now, maybe one more thing. I'm going to try to move a leader over to here, try to help rally that man. So we'll get Bagration's aid, Minsgorod. And that will conclude our movement. Now for defensive fire, we only have 2 places in contact. So we'll quickly throw the dice here. Two 1.5-to-1 attacks, both yield no results. If we move on to the offensive fire phase, a couple of low numbers, so no fire casualties there at all. The Russians are not going to attempt any melee, so we can move right to the morale recovery phase here. See that one disordered battalion? And we remember that the Russians are on level 2, which is -6 to all rolls. So we rolled a pretty poor number, 13. On a morale level, there's no chance he passed that. So he will rout. We have no cavalry to recover, so we can just kind of move to the route movement phase, which is this one unit. And for good or for ill, they're in clear terrain here, so they basically get to run their full night movement allowance away. So that will conclude our Russian turn. The lines didn't move that much, but the Russians took some serious casualties and have really thinned out in the center and the left. The French paid dearly for those gains, taking quite a few heavy hits here in the center among the grenadiers. So the next turn will bring us darker, deeper into night. The French are getting near the edge of the vineyard here in the east. Still a ways to go in the center, and they probably will be lost forever in the west here.